Bottom Books fans, this is Scorp1701, and tonight we are going to be taking a look at another figure from the Princess Bride Wave 2 from McFarlane Toys, and this is going to be the Dread Pirate Roberts, the Bloodied variant. And yes, this is pretty much the same figure that we saw before as the Dread Pirate Roberts, although it has a different head and he has some battle damage. So, taking a look at the box, you can see it's in the new box with the cool designs here at the top, but it's mostly all black. You can see Wesley in there. You can see the Princess Bride, Dread Pirate Roberts Bloodied. On this side of the box, you have the Princess Bride, Wesley and Buttercup, McFarlane Toys. On this side of the box, the Princess Bride, Dread Pirate Roberts Bloodied, McFarlane Toys. On the bottom of the box, you get some credits for the box and a barcode. On the top of the box, you get the cool little flowery designs and the Princess Bride and McFarlane Toys 12 Plus. If you can see that, yep, there it is. And on the back of the box, you have the Princess Bride, the same picture we got with the first Dread Pirate Roberts figures. And you can see Princess Buttercup, Vizzini, and Inigo Montoya, 22 moving parts, and some more credits for the box. And that is Wesley in the box. But no one wants to see this new version of Wesley in the box. I know I don't, so let's get him out and see what he can do. And here we have Wesley out of the package. And out of the package, he stands 7 inches tall, and he comes with a couple of accessories. He comes with his Princess Bride figure stand, which is all round and just has a foot peg in there that he can step on. We've seen these a million times, but they are really nice to have because sometimes the figures don't want to stand up on their own. And he comes with his awesome sword, which is nice. Silver and some black, nice molded detail here. It's kind of flimsy, but you put it in the sheath, it will kind of bend right back into spot. And this is the exact same one we got with the previous figure. No difference in it whatsoever. Doesn't even have some R-O-U-S-S's blood on the blade to, you know, justify him being battle damage, but that's okay. I guess if you had some red paint, you could do that yourself. And that's his accessories. We're going to move really quickly into the figure himself, getting in real close. Let's take a look at the Dread Pirate himself. And coming real close in on the Dread Pirate Roberts, one of the biggest and best things about this figure is he no longer has the black mask and head covering. And they did a pretty good job on the sculpt. I'm not sure if it's 100% dead on for Cary Elwes, but you know, it's different, it's neat. And you can see that he has a lot of cool facial features in there. And starting off looking at his head, it is nicely sculpted with a lot of hair in there, and the hair is molded different ways, and you got a lock going here, and it comes around to the back of the head, and that is really nicely done. And you have a nice little rat tail here. I like that. That is cool. I'm glad they added that. Coming around to the side, you got his little mole here, and some nice facial features. You got his mustache, which we saw in the other one. The eyes are bright blue. I'm not sure if we can get in there, if it's coming across on camera, but it is very nice blue eyes in the figure. I do like that. Let's see if we can get some light in there. I'm not sure if the light's making it come across. Does appear to have some more stubble on his face than the other one did. The other one did have stubble, but this entire neck is covered, it looks like. And coming down, you do have a different color tunic. It's very, very slight, and it's not exactly black. It almost appears like they threw some like really, really dark brown in there. It's not exactly how it was on the other one, and we'll get a look at that in just a minute. Then coming over to his shoulder, this whole arm piece has kind of been remolded. He got half of this little chainmail type thingy he wore, like you can see over here, and then you have the open shoulder, and then you have the blood paint on there. That is really nicely done. And if you look really closely into the wound, you can see that there are indentions and marks which would indicate the R-O-U-S-S's teeth, and that is really neat. So, alright, coming down, tunic for the most part is the same, and then coming down to his hands, the left hand is now ungloved, so you got a regular hand there instead of the gloved hand over here. Not sure why they didn't give us both ungloved hands, but they did not. And then you have your standard belt here with his sheath attached to it, and the same sheath, same looking design that we got before, coming down to the black pants and the nice cuffed boots. Really like that. And on the back again, nothing that is any different here. Let's zoom out just a hair and you can see them. And if we zoom all the way out, we can see another man in black. So I like to always bring in the first figure if we are going to be doing these kind of comparisons, which is going to be neat because for the most part they are going to be the same, but I would like to take a look at them regardless. So let me get the original one here to stand. He's having kind of being kind of finicky, so move over, zoom in so we can see the face on both of these. So yeah, again, you had a lot less you had to worry about when you had the headpiece and the mask on there. Here, you did have to do some sculpt work, but then coming down, you can see that they are pretty much identical when it comes to the outfits. You know, just a few things I talked about with the missing glove and the remolded piece where the battle damage is. And you might be able to tell the difference in the tunics. Can't really tell on the camera, but if you have it in hand, you could tell that this is a different color than this tunic. But again, not a big deal. All right, and that is what your Wesleys are going to look like. Moving on. And here's one of the best reasons that you need both of these figures. The heads are interchangeable, and I think it looks great. I love the fact that you could just take the heads and put them on the different bodies. And if you work it around a little bit and take some parts from Inigo, you can even give Wesley two flesh hands, and that is cool. And so you can have a basic Wesley. So in case you were wondering, yes, the parts are interchangeable, just like they were with Inigo Montoya. All right, moving on. And for a quick articulation rundown, starting at the head can go around 360 degrees. It can look down, it can look up, it can look from side to side, so that is really cool. He does have articulation in the shoulders. Shoulders can go around 360 degrees. They are hinged, so they can come up really far and then back down. He does have a bicep rotation right here below the bloodiness, and that is funny. And then he comes down to a built-in elbow bend, which is nice. You can see it is hinged, but you know, you do get somewhat about 90 degrees, not much after that. And the forearm is very large. It does have a rotation in it, so that is cool. And then that will bring you down to the hand, and the hand is articulated in and out. Turn the ball joint around, it can go up and down, and that is pretty much every which way you need to move your hand. Coming to the waist articulation, he does have 360 degrees waist right here. He does kind of have a wiggly waggly in the upper torso, so you can kind of move it off to the side and back. I wouldn't consider it an ab crunch, but you do get a little bit of motion there. You can move the sheath around 360 degrees. Just make sure, you know, it gets out of the way of what you're trying to do, but it does wiggle and waggle. The leg can go up and then back a good ways. He does come out to the side as well. Then you get a double hinged knee joint, which is very nice. You get a lot of motion right there, so he can actually kick himself in the butt if he was so inclined. When it comes to thigh rotation, yeah, a little bit. I wouldn't say it goes all the way around, but you do get a little in and out. And as far as boot cut, I don't think there is anything here, but we will see. No, there's nothing for boot cut rotation. And when you come down to the foot, it is on a hinge, so it can go up and it can go down and it can go all the way around on a rocker. and that is really cool. And then you have some toe articulation up and down. So, yeah, a lot of articulation for this guy. Nothing really gets in the way. And it's really nice to get him into different poses. All right, moving on. And for comparison, here you have Wave 1 Buttercup, Wave 1 Fezzik, and Wave 2 Indigo. And it's kind of interesting to see how different a little bit of blood and Maskless face makes the group. I really do like the new head sculpt. The bloody shoulder is kind of distracting, but so is the entire tunic of Indigo. So it's just one of those weird little gimmicks. So take it or leave it. That's pretty much what it looks like in the group. All right, moving on. And this has been the McFarlane Toys The Princess Bride Wave 2 Dread Pirate Roberts Bloodied Version. And he is okay. I love the fact that he has a maskless head, and I think that makes the figure worth the pickup, because you can interchange the head, and if you don't like the bloody version, you can put the head on the clean body, and it gives you a version of how he looked through most of the movie. In addition to the maskless head, you have the bloody wound and the remolded shoulder, and finally you have the gloveless left hand. So there's not a lot of difference in this figure, and if you're one of those people who are happy with the mask version, then you probably won't want to pick this up. But if you want to mix and match the pieces, definitely want to pick this up to change out the head. The sword is the same. It is, like I said, flimsy. You put it in the sheath, it will gain its shape back, but right now you can see it's still kind of misshapen, but you know, it's plastic and it's not a big deal. So anyway, that is going to be this guy. If you're looking for him, you can pick him up at retailers right now, and he goes anywhere between $25 to $30, depending on where you find him. So if you're looking for him, happy hunting. All right, guys, that's the video. Hope you enjoyed it. And until next time, keep playing.